thought current which can liberate you from all the thought currents. I should not even say thought current, it's like a kundalini current which can liberate you from all thought currents. I initiated all of you in Shivaratri day. I'll remind you all, I am what my intention to be. Anything other than that, physiological, psychological, neurological ups and downs are not me. Now today, few organic fertilizers to grow this thought current. Organic fertilizers to grow this kundalini current. Thought current is too poor word. Kundalini current. For example, if I tell you, think about a beautiful river and a hills, that can be called as thought current. But if I tell you, remember, you are just what you want to be, and all the physiological, psychological, neurological ups and downs are not you, it cannot be called as thought current. When you entertain that in your life, that should be called as kundalini current. It's not thought current. So that's the difference. Whatever liberates you can't be called as thought currents. That is kundalini current. Every kundalini current make your whole system as bliss pot. Your whole blood, bone marrow, everything becomes such beautiful, such beautiful bliss overflow. What you strongly believe inside you as your fundamental right. Listen, all of us strongly believe some things as our fundamental right. That freedom should not be touched, because I go through whatever I go through which I don't want in my life just for that one thing. So all of you look into, what do you think as your fundamental right? Listen. What you feel, what you believe as your fundamental right, that plays a major role. Because when you are alone, you boil down only to your, what do you think as your fundamental right? A man who thinks, I tolerate all this just for the sake of money, who thinks money is his fundamental pleasure, fundamental right, naturally he will become rich. He will be working only towards wealth and he will become rich. But he will not be fulfilled. Please understand, whatever you think as your fundamental right, you equate that and your life. You are ready to bargain with your life to gain that. Sometime yes from girlfriend, sometime yes from a business proposal, sometime yes for pleasure. Whatever you equate as your fundamental right in your life, you will get that, no doubt. But be very clear, you will never be fulfilled by that, because actually your fundamental right is to build the bliss chemistry in you. Anything other than that, you will feel you have been cheated or you wasted your life on it. There are so many things in your life which you don't like, you do it just for the sake of what you think is the fundamental pleasure of your life. Anything you think as your fundamental right, for which you go through whatever you go through in your life, whether it's money, name and fame, relationships, pleasure, you will get that. But by that very thing which you equated your life to, you will feel cheated by that. No pleasure, no money, no power, no girlfriend, even if it's Miss Universe or Miss Cosmos or Mr. Cosmos, no one can equate your life. Understand, your fundamental right is building your own bliss chemistry, where you are independently able to fall into the joy and bliss just by your intention, your will. Ability to fall into the bliss chemistry just by your will, independent of anything else, is your fundamental right. Every child should be taught this is your fundamental right. One beauty of this Kundalini current is you don't have to do anything. Just decision is enough, because the fundamental, what you claim, believe, think as your fundamental right, is the first layer thought current which diverts you from your existence as pure you into your physiological, psychological, neurological ups and downs. Listen. See, one side, your physiological, neurological, psychological ups and downs. Other side, that pure you, your intention to be Sadashiva. It can be Murugan Swami for some people, Sadashiva for some people, or whatever, for some people Nityanandoham, whatever, it's up to you. But your pure intention to be is one side, and your physiological, psychological, neurological ups and downs, the other side. What actually bridges these two, you know? What you believe as your fundamental right, that only connects this. And that is where all delusion starts. All delusion. Feeling cheated, feeling as a victim, feeling deprived, feeling hounded, feeling attacked, feeling not being attended enough, or feeling life is waste, or feeling within you that you are not enough, hatred towards you, all. Everything, that delusion, that thought current, starts by what you believe as your fundamental right. Your fundamental right is to build a bliss chemistry in your system, in which you can get in, enjoy, just by your will, independent of anything outside. independent of anything outside. This is the fundamental right. Understand the beauty of this Kundalini current is the moment you remember this is your fundamental right, all other fundamental right bridges are given, it is blasted. Automatically it collapses. It just collapses. Listen. One side the pure consciousness, you. The other side, your neurological, physiological, psychological ups and downs. Why will you first of all feel associated yourself with this? Because this side, this neurological, physiological ups and downs, dangles the carrot and says, come, come here, I'll give you a lot of excitement. We will have a roller coaster. See. We will go in giant wheel. We have a circus running here. You can have cotton candy. So the moment you think any one of this is your fundamental right, the bondage bridge starts. The bridge bondage starts. Whatever you think as your fundamental right, whether you are given or not, you are cheated. Your fundamental right is bliss chemistry in which you can enter into just by your intention, will, independent of anything else. Independent of anything else. When you understand this, all other bridges are blasted away. It is not to be practiced, just but to be decided. Understand? If you practice, your future will be transformed, is yogic techniques. If you practice, immediately your future will be transformed is tantric techniques. If you decide, your past, present, future, all three will be transformed is a Shaivite techniques. Mahadeva is Mahakala. He just lands. The moment he lands, past, present, future, everything is he alone. My fundamental right is to build a bliss chemistry inside me, independent of anything external. Declare this. Cherish this Kundalini current. Cherish this decision. It will burn all other delusional bridges. You will not become poor. You will be rich. You will have more pleasure. More beautiful things in your life. All that, independent of the slavery you experience with that. Listen. All that, independent of the slavery you experience with those external items. I tell you, be blissful because you are Mahadeva, not because you got yes for some your proposal in your relationship or business deal. Be blissful because you are Mahadeva. I am blissful because I am Mahadeva. Consciously, the reason you chose
the reason you choose to be blissful builds your bliss chemistry. You don't need to worry about the unconscious reasons which makes you joyful. The moment money comes, you will be joyful. The moment you get yes from your proposal from boyfriend or girlfriend, you will be joyful. The moment you get yes from a business proposal, you will be joyful. Those are all unconscious joys. You don't need to have guilt about them. You don't need to worry about them. Consciously you build the bliss chemistry. I am joyful because I am Mahadeva. I am my intention to be. This consciously deciding to be joyful because your intention to be is building bliss chemistry in you, independent of anything external. Cherish this Kundalini current. Cherish, decide, entertain, enjoy, celebrate this one Kundalini current. I am what I want to be, my intention, my fundamental right is building my bliss chemistry independent of anything external. Cherish, 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 entertain, enjoy, celebrate this beautiful Kundalini current. You will be ready. You will be ready for more mystical powers in Kumbh Mela, to receive in Kumbh Mela. Be blissful because you are what your intention to be. Your physiological, psychological, neurological ups and downs are not you. Neither down nor up. Both are not you. It is not that you will not enjoy if you know the ups are not you. Not that you will not enjoy. You will enjoy independently, freely, without the side effect of down. The side effect of up is down. Without the side effect of down, you will be celebrating. Because whether up comes or goes, you know you are not up. When you know you are not ups and downs, don't worry that ups will be taken away from you. Only the downs disappear, ups become your natural flow of existence. When you don't care, you go higher than ups and downs. Higher than ups and downs means up, 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 up. Any small thing, you will enjoy. There won't be any requirement for something big for you to fall into your bliss chemistry. You are a teddy bear soaked in honey. Nothing much is required for you to make the honey as an experience for you and others. Just a small touch is enough. You will also be enjoying the sweet and you will share that with others. Your senses does not need to be excited for your bliss. Your ideas does not need to be accredited, recognized for bliss. You are blissful just because what you intend to be. You are what you intend to be. Be blissful because you are Mahadeva.